your wands and pick up your knife and fork. It's time for another UD Foodie Review.
And we find ourselves at Universal Orlando Resort City Walk. And in case you're not familiar with this place, this is actually the shopping and dining area that sits outside of the two parks, those two parks being Universal Studios Florida and Islands of Adventure. This does not cost you anything to get into this area, so feel free to come in. They have restaurants, they have movie theaters, they have stores, and those stores, restaurants, are always changing. So, get over here and give this thing a try. If you haven't been here in years, then probably, I'm sure, there are a lot of new things in it. If you're not sure what's there, keep an eye. We're always reviewing this area and the restaurants and stuff that exist in it. Okay, so let's get on with the food. On this trip, we went to the NBC Grill and Brew, which is the restaurant's been here now probably 2 years. It took up the space that was originally the NBA. It was an NBA restaurant, NBA-themed restaurant. The NBC Grill and Brew is good in the two or three times now that I've been in it. But we're going to go through on this trip the Loaded Chili Nachos, the Bang Bang Chicken, the Grand Slam Burger, and the Meatloaf Panini. Let me stop real quick here at the first thing. And that first thing is the Loaded Grilled Nachos at $14.95. They consist of chili beans, white queso, aged cheddar, sour cream, scallions, pico de gallo, guacamole, and jalapenos. Guys, if there's two to three of you, you can get this and stop right there. On this trip, we had no idea how big this order was. I've actually gotten it once or twice more since we actually did this review because it is so good and it is so filling. And for $14.95, I'm telling you, you can easily fill up two of you with just this one order. And if you're just looking for a somewhat filling snack for three people, this can be done. So if you're looking to save some money and get filled up and actually eat something that is really good that you would get, not just to try to save money, but you would get because you actually really want something you can enjoy and really get your money's worth, this is the thing to get. We're gonna move on though. I'm just telling you right now, there's nothing in the Loaded Chili Nachos that you will not like. So give those a try. Next is the Bang Bang Chicken. This is the meal that I actually got. It is at $14.95, it's a Thai dish with the flavors of curry, peanut, chili, coconut, sauteed vegetables, and jasmine rice. It doesn't have a very good presentation. It doesn't look like it would be very good. The flavor of it is more like it was a very sweet Thai. And I'm used to maybe sometimes a little more of more curry and less of the sweet. I think that sweet is coming from the chili and the coconut combined. It wasn't bad. Would I get it again? I probably would not get this again. But if you do like the sweet Thai flavor, then this would definitely be something for you to try. As you can see, there is a lot of it. So once again, this is one of those meals that if you are into the sweet Thai taste, you could definitely split this between two of you. This was a lot of food. So anyway, give this a try if it is something that you think you might be into. Next is the Grand Slam Burger. This is what Connor got. And that is a 2 half-pound beef patties, applewood smoked bacon, cheddar cheese, bib lettuce, tomato, crispy Tabasco onions, barbecue ranch, and that is served on a brioche bun, a toasted brioche bun. And the toasted is a really good idea, as with many sandwiches, when they don't toast that bun and they put all of these different ingredients on there, you end up with a soggy bun. In case I didn't say, this is $19.95. This is an expensive burger. But from what Connor said, it was delicious. Very good hamburger. Everything on it tasted fresh, well done, and had a really good taste. Many times, I think even when I went to Twosome recently and I got their burger that had many items like this on it with bacon and cheese and burger and maybe even a brisket or something else. Sometimes what you get into is many of the items on the burger begin to mix together and just taste the same. So you really can't taste that difference between the tomato and the bacon and the burger and maybe the onions and stuff that are on it. This was not the case on this one. So expensive at $19.95, I think, for a hamburger. But if you're looking for a burger and you're really a hamburger person, this is one to fill up on. And so we're going to move on from there. The next one is the one that my father-in-law got. He got the meatloaf panini at $12.95. It's hot-pressed brisket meatloaf, ham, Swiss, pickles, mustard, and that's on a Cuban bread, and they actually just press it. And so you end up with those little signature stripes kind of burned into the panini itself. My father-in-law loved this sandwich, and he said he would definitely get it again. He said that the brisket meatloaf gave a whole different taste, a much finer taste to the meatloaf itself. That mixed with the saltiness of the ham, and then that kind of flat, I don't want to say bitter taste of the Swiss cheese, but you know, we all have eaten Swiss cheese. You kind of know what that tastes like. It has that kind of, a neutral taste to it. With that, and then the pickles and the mustard, he said was just fantastic. All of it together, and the sandwich when it came to the table was still very nice and warm, like they pressed it just before they came to the table. So these three things at $14.95 for the loaded chili nachos, that is one that you can split, do by yourself. The Grand Slam Burger, you could split, do by yourself. The meatloaf panini was probably, if you're a fairly hefty eater, then this is probably going to be a one-and-done sandwich. Not one-and-done that you're going to eat it once and then be done, but really just one-person sandwich. If you're both light eaters, you want something to just get through the day, you could definitely get this sandwich and split it. So remember, as always, guys, 10% to 20% discount if you have that preferred annual pass. So always keep that in mind when you're considering the amount of days that you're going to be on property. If you're staying on property, it's also a good idea to have that preferred annual pass for discounts. This thing will pay for itself quickly. So before you just order tickets and stick to that, give this a thought. All right, thanks, and we'll be back with you all again soon. Bye-bye.